their general aggression is off the charts, and Hellraiser's played it a lot more passively, but it seemed that the aggressive option was the better one.
For LDLC, at least, they know how to do it.
Indeed.
So, I mean, they're super comfortable with those calls. That's one of the reasons why they are awesome. And we're going to see awesomeness here from Overpower. Already wanting to just get into the thick of it here on the B bomb site. As Devil says, push B and win. That's how this map, in a sentence. Push B and win. And we're going to see a lot of winning right now, as Cloud9 is off to a bit of a poor start. Nothing is now reduced to a corpse on the ground. A lifeless husk. But
ooh,
we do have a pause, and that was, that's great.
Okay, so we have a bit of a ping issue here, so we'll see if they calm down. Looks like they are going down, so they're going to resume the game, which is great news for all concerned. So IBPower do take that first round, and we'll see what kind of reaction we get here from Cloud9. I'm expecting a full eco here. I don't think they're going to be spending the cash just yet. You can see IBPower buying up swag with the AK there. And P250 on steel, which may be from the last round. He does have two kills in the bag so far.
Oh, I've got a good one. If Steel was a character from Game of Thrones, who would he be?
Tyrion Lannister.
You said that last time! You said that about Forrest on the European cast.
Yeah.
You're just saying Tyrion Lannister every time I ask you.
Well, it's okay, so go on in. Who do you... Are you talking lookalike or kind of character-wise?
I reckon he would be Peter Baelish.
I was thinking Baelish as well, yeah.
Like, but no, how, but you said said Tyrion Lannister. You can't. I was thinking this guy. I didn't say.
It's just more fun.
That makes no sense, James. You are off the chain. All right. Well, either way, we're continuing into things here.
You made me think of toilets. Did you ever have a toilet where it was like a chain? You had to pull the chain to flush a toilet.
No.
Well, speaking of going off the chain and toilets, we are in the sewers here with Dazed. Who's going to be looking for the ecoing CTs? We have three CZs, a 5.7 and a P250. So Cloud9 looking to do some damage here. Oh, they've gone for the armor buy as well. So they have bought after all. Looking for the... I mean, this is a CT favored map, and I suppose they're going to play the angles. You can see nothing, just hugging the walls here. Gonna have a peek and get some information, but they won't see the bomb just yet. The bomb is left around the T-spawn area, so there's going to be doubt here for Cloud9. You can see one of their players rotating upstairs, presuming the bomb is possibly going in that direction. But it's only just been picked up now, and it is going to go towards the B site. Nothing is going to go down on the B site. Now it's going to leave it open for the five players of IBP. So we can see Eco gets the first one down there. That 5-7 showing its worth, and we're going to have the flank from Sean Garrett, but he has been spotted already, and see what Hiko can do here. He does go down to Daze, finding his head with that AK, and Sean Garrett, let's see what he's trying to do here. He's got his knife out at the moment, so it's not going to be optimal, but CZ is out. He can hear the play running, but he's not going to be able to connect with those bullets. No armor, and Steel will take him down.
I think Sean Garrett needs to fix his keyboard. He's got an abundance of S's going on right now.
Indeed.
It's a gratuitous use of the letter S. So we're going to see 2-0 now for IBPower. And they are certainly looking pretty good now. We're actually seeing that Tech 9 on AZK, which makes me like him just that much more. As people are still trying to use the Tech 9, before eventually they'll realize that the CZ is... It would never be as good as the CZ.
Worth noting that IBPower have two players who don't have rifles here. So again, it may be that strat that we have seen from Fnatic where they use the pistolers as bait. However, that said, they are fairly spread out around the map. And Steel will take out Shroud, but nothing will get the trade kill with a USPS. So let's see what kind of approach we have for the rest of this round. Daze will take out Semphis. They're going to approach the B site. Going to bounce that nade off into that corner, and that won't be the end of Hiko, as he is protected by those barrels.
And a 3-on-3 situation here.
Bomb is in the hands of the CTs now, and nothing has an AK. So, IBPower in trouble. Maybe they should have gone for those extra two guns after all. It is a 2-1. It's a 3-on-2 now.
Yep,
however,
be done though by Iber Power. They just need to get Dazed in the right position here. Swag picks up the bomb. It's all about cutting the path between Dazed and that bomber. Dazed with a good reaction there. If he can actually continue just holding this position on the B bomb site, but he will get taken down by nothing, and that is going to spell mighty problems here for Swag. But he did take down one player, which means that at worst he can be facing a 1-on-1 hit. But the problem is his health really. That smoke could just allow him to get the bomb down. He's just going to go for the quick plant. This is really smart now. Nothing going to come in from one side, and Sean Gares from another. And Swag will get the bomb down. And he even has potentially a chance with a quick snap, if he's successful in that snap, to win the round even. But the bomb is down, so he's secured that $800 all around for his teammates. Ooh, Swag gets the first kill straight away. And it might just be around for him if he finds ahead, and he does nothing. Gonna get sent flying by that AK of Swag, and what a save to the round. Cloud 9 must be gutted.
Pure confidence there from Swag. Clutches the round up for his teammates, and Sean Gares is gonna pick up the AWP here, and let's see where he takes it for Cloud 9. They are 3 rounds down. Again, I think Cloud 9 were favored in the skin betting on this map, but again, it's Iber Power who always come out with the goods against them. So we'll see if this road to victory continues for IBP. They are 3 rounds up. Trades are coming in. AZK gets 2 fast picks on the B site. That's going to clear it up. Only Senfis remaining to hold it down. And he is going to fall to AZK as well. So AZK coming in with the big frags here in round 4.
Sean Gares is going to open up onto Steel through the wall. As we have Shroud coming in. Oh my god, just 6 cents there through the wall as Shroud will nail AZK. Swag trying to play the bomb timer. Ooh, does reveal his position, and it's not going to do him any good as we do see the bomb defuse for the first round here for Cloud 9. And so, oh, actually, he doesn't have a kit. He doesn't have a kit, but he has enough time. That's good for him and his team. So, very nice stuff there by Cloud 9. I'm going to put that first round up on the board. And this is certainly going to allow them to start bringing things back into control. However, the money is still going to more than allow a buy from Iber Power. But that's that open Sean Gares, that's where things can get interesting. But also, something that we've seen a lot of the European teams being completely spot on is a lot of these spots and these wall bangs on this map, which there's a million boosts in one on this map. But this is fast and chaotic here. So very aggressive. Into positions here for this B push. Gonna take down nothing already on the entry. And they mean business right now. Cloud9 pushed to a very quick defense here. Pushed all the way back onto that site. It's like a steal on position towards that bomb plant spot itself. But they can't quite get the bomb over there just yet. And Cloud9 are holding pretty well. Sean Gares with the AWP in the back. Able to secure some very key kills. Swag and Skadoodle very low at this point. And looks to be Cloud9's round. But would you want to count Iber Power out just yet? 50 seconds on the board.
They do have the AKs after all, so they could pop the heads if necessary. But Skadoodle does have a smoke out at the moment, so he needs to be careful here. I'm wondering what the Iber Power team are waiting for. They're probably just burning down the clock, waiting for the CTs to rotate, although Skadoodle doesn't seem to be moving at the moment, and he will fall, which makes me wonder if he's still connected to the server, because that did look kind of odd. And Swag will fall, so we'll see if there's any comments here. Indeed, we have a pause, so it looks like maybe Skadoodle has dropped from the server.
Okay, if Steel was a vegetable, which vegetable would he be?
Tyrion Lannister.
You bastard, James.
If Steel was a vegetable, what vegetable would he be? A turnip.
Turnip. I don't know if I don't remember the last time I actually ate a turnip.
Me neither.
It's quite an obscure one that you picked out there.
What would you pick?
It's quite a difficult one. I'd say broccoli.
Okay.
Good stuff. We can move on now.
Absolutely. I think that's a good idea.
We settled it, and now we can move forwards with our lives. Okay, so we're going to have to see. Wait to see if Iber Power can bring the player back onto the server. And hopefully this is not an issue that is going to extend over the period of more than a minute or two. As we're so good on schedule today, James.
Indeed, and hopefully it does continue that way during this last match and there are no shenanigans, so we'll see what happens here. And in the meantime, let's look at what we can and see who's getting the frags, etc. So it seems fairly spread out on Cloud 9's side at the moment. It's getting slowly back into this round match. They are one round down to iBuy Power, and we'll see what has become of Skadoodle. One of the flashiest AWPers, if not the flashiest AWPer on the American scene, at least that we've seen in this league. And I have seen some more up-and-coming American teams who aren't necessarily in this league at the moment, and it will be cool to see them hopefully in future events here. But for the time being, we have got Cloud9 versus iBuyPower. And I think somebody asked me on Twitter if these two had ever faced on this map before or played it competitively at all. And I'm not aware of any matches that either of these guys have played. I'm sure they will have scrimmed against other teams. You know, these pro teams are scrimming off stream all the time.
Well, I do remember that. Do you remember the... I think it was, yeah, it was Cloud9. They had that match versus NIP on an ESL1 in Cologne, where they played them on Cobble, right? And they said that they basically weren't able to find practice on Cobble. They had, like, played half a map of Cobble before going into that tournament. I don't know if that would be the same
story. They played that on Cobble, and then that left at half time.
Yeah.
Oh, dearie me.
I didn't notice that, actually. That's really funny. And that would have been during the event, then.
Minus Cobble plus Seaside. That's what I'm saying. I want to see Seaside played competitively. It's a fun map. I think B might be a bit too hard to breach.
No, play Seaside.
Really? Yeah, well, Seaside is a very enjoyable map. And there are really crazy things you can do from CT spawn as well. What does need fixing, though, is that the CT spawn on a pier. And if you throw a gun, there's a chance it can fall through the cracks of the pier before the round even starts. Just go into the water, and that's goodbye to the gun. So that doesn't need patching. But the parts that hold up the pier, you can jump like off the side of the pier and just hide in sneaky positions on these diagonal pieces of wood, which are brilliant and can cause all kinds of mayhem. So that's always fun. But Seaside was a popular map along with Agency, but that's a hostage map, Agency, so we're not going to see that in competitive. But it would be nice to say have a Seaside only tournament, you know, just a fun tournament between professional players. That would be fun. But with all the leagues and tournaments, there isn't really the time
to
do such a thing these days.
Already hard. I mean, it's already going to be the fact that teams are going to be competing, or rather, leagues will be competing to have teams just play their leagues, because there's going to be so many darn leagues popping up here, there, and everywhere. So it's getting crazy up in the CSGO scene. This game is really growing, expanding at a rapid pace. And we're already back in with Skadoodle. So that was a very brief pause. That's how I like him. Didn't even have to tell any weird jokes, which I'm...
Hey, that's always good. It's like Christmas when DDK doesn't tell a weird joke. So
I like it when it gets awkward in here.
Alrighty then. Don't know where to go with that, but iBuyPower are on the eco. They're not going to get any frags just yet, although nothing does go down. And only Skadoodle remains. So this is going to be a fast round, a veritable slaughter for the Cloud9 side. So that is going to be a little confidence boost there. They're back on even terms. But again, this is what we currently feel is a CT map. One of the reasons is because of the difficulty for the T side to rotate between sites, but the way LDRC were playing it there earlier on today on the European stream showed that they, if you take like 2/3 of the map control, then it makes it a little bit easier for you. But if the CT side take aggressive positions, like we're seeing here from Cloud9, then it's not going to be as easy as that.
Yeah, this is really very smart of Cloud9 to do this, and this is what a lot of teams have started to do, just move out to take more aggressive positions and fall back until eventually you're on the site and see what you can do, try to deny positions as long as possible. And looks like we do have Shroud maybe on the right side. He might just soon find himself a couple players as the bomb is, you know, moving towards that A site at the moment. But the interesting thing as well is that LDLC were hitting the A site more than I've seen any team do it before, and they were making it work a lot.
Yeah, they were putting more bodies on upper and the connector area than lower, which makes sense because you have the sewers there, so there's a funnel. There's only so many people you can put through those and have it be useful anyway. And you can see IBP Power now, they've sped up. Now they've got the pick on Shroud. They've got the man advantage, and they want to use and abuse it. Going to have Steel going around the corner, so make sure there's no flank here from any CT players hiding. But we are going to have the Cloud9 team ready with the counter flashes here on the A bomb site. Scudito was going to see it coming from a mile away and look down to the ground, not get flashed. So we'll see if Semphis can hold the site here.
And there you go, through the smokes. Some wall of smokes is going to be Semphis to find a bit of a hole there to just take down AZK, as we are having the fight from Cloud9 up those steps into the site for the retake. It's going to be pretty clean for them. I mean, going to have three players left alive. And so we can check the odds here very quickly. And it seems to be a relatively even, although favored Cloud9 when it's the skins. But
yeah, but Cloud9,
the money,
it's interesting.
On the IBP.
It's interesting that Cloud9 are favored because they do pretty much always lose to IBP Power, but I don't know.
They're the fan favorite team at the moment.
Indeed they are, but I think when you see their performance on LAN and see how better they do compared to IBP Power, it's hard to bet against them. But when they go head-to-head, IBP Power just seems to bring that W each time, and they're doing well on the T side of this map so far. But this is yet another eco from them now, and we'll see if they can get the bomb down. Not looking likely though, Hiko having none of it. Going to get some pistol kills after the M4 runs out of bullets there. And it's only going to be minimal damage here for the CT side. They've got lots of money in his bank. Sean Garris with an AWP in his hand, and his bank is still in double figures. There is going to be an AWP on Skadoodle as well, so now things are really going to start to heat up.
Alright, Skadoodle. Sean Garris. The aggressive plays here from Cloud9 already just taking some forward positions in the map to make sure that they can slow the approach by IBP Power. Maybe just pick one off before they do get to that that play. Seems like they are focusing a lot on the B bomb side. It's certainly been favorable for IBP Power so far. See if Skadoodle can see some legs there. Barely, I'm not seeing them, as we do have Cloud9 slowly making their way back now that they've been pushed, and now that Skadoodle is going to find a pick. So it's all on IBP Power to slowly get the positions that they need now to move on to a site. And we are going to see Shroud making his way. Ooh, Steel's right around the corner, and in it goes. And the spray from Shroud is not going to be enough, and Steel will make the frag.
I wonder if Shroud realized that that was Steel's shadow on the floor there. It kind of did look like some shrubbery as well, so he may not have twigged, no pun intended, at what was going on there. So that's unfortunate for him. And it's going to be two of his hombres left versus four IBP Power brethren who are going to charge towards the B-bomb site and get the bomb down there, hopefully. There we go. He's all missing his shot with the AWP. They're going to go for the nade instead. Going to put Semphis down to 70 HP, and Cloud9 do have a decision to make here. It's going to be a hard to impossible retake, 2 versus 4. So it's going to bide their time for the moment, and Hiko is in an aggressive position, so he's going to go for it here.
Ooh. Skadoodle. Skadoodle doodle doo. And you said no pun intended, but I think that was very intended there.
No, I'm just... Maybe...
I've never said twig before in your life.
Maybe subconsciously, but my vocabulary knows no bounds, DDK. No knows.
Easily beans.
Cloud9 taking the lead now after losing the pistol. 5-4 in their favor. They're going to need a lot more rounds than that if they are to mount a reasonable comeback on the T side, should they need one.
Well, I mean, certainly if they're able to pick up 6 to 7, 8 rounds, I mean, they're going to be incredibly happy. Certainly, you know, the CT side does have a bit of an advantage. I mean, let's not forget that. We do have Daze trying to tap away at some headset, but Sean Gares can get taken down by that as we see the trace coming in across the map. It's actually a man up here for Cloud9 as they try to fall back, but it is a swag that does take down Shroud. So still a man up on Cloud9 as they fall back onto the sites. And this is actually quite favorable in many spots for the CTs, especially on this map, where the rotation between both sites is so incredibly quick that even being a man down is not such a huge disadvantage for the CTs, as usually the reason for that is due to the rotation and having to cover two sites at once. And we're going to see now Steel making his way in as nothing rests patiently.
You can see his shadow again. Steel, if he pushes this angle, shadow will be exposed there. But nothing, the flash only gets in by half. And we'll see if this takes out Swag. Yes, that second flash will hit him, but he can still see enough to get the frag here. 20 seconds remaining, so he may opt to go for the safer. You can see him slowly inching away from the site, and he is going to make his exit. Doesn't know where all the CCs are, though, so it is going to be a slow exit. Going to make sure he doesn't run into somebody with an M4. 5 seconds remaining now, and we'll see if he can save this AWP. Again, looking at the pushes we had on Cash yesterday, Virtus Pro, they had an eco with an AWP buying pistols, and they won. Was it against Nip?
It was Cash, wasn't it? It was... Wait, I can actually find that out real quick. That was yesterday, right?
Yep.
I'm gonna find that out. I've got my notes. Let's have a look. It was against... Was that SLTV? No.
Yep.
Yes. Then that would have been against Virtus Pro.
Virtus Pro were the ones who did it.
Titan.
Unless it was Virtus Pro versus Virtus Pro.
Titan then. It was Titan.
Marvelous.
Titan. Virtus Pro. Alright. Now I've lost my current notes.
Okay. So the first frag does go to Shroud. Second frag does go to Shroud. So that is going to be a nice advantage there for Cloud9, but Daze does take Shroud down and stop his reign of tyranny here in the upper part of this overpass map. And I don't know if the bomb's been seen yet by the CTs, but they are going to play it tentatively. Swag just hanging out in these gardens, admiring the trees. And we will have Sean Garrez trying to play the range, trying to put max distance between himself and his enemies while he holds that site. And we're going to have Senfis in a sneaky position here. Going to take out Skidoo in the toilets and then find Dazed afterwards. And it's going to be Swag versus 4. So we'll see. His position probably hasn't been exposed. But
GLHF.
But I think the CTs have made estimates as to where he might be. But they're making sure...
Oh, it gets a nice tag. But the problem with this map is that even if they're all on the A site, I mean, he's still losing this round. This is the big problem is that rotation distance is ridiculously quick to either side. So it's a pretty much a no brainer here from Cloud9, and Swag will actually be able to save this weapon. Yes, barely able to do it as of course the HP there. But a 7-4 the rounds here for Cloud9. They are in the lead. And this is more or less going as you expect it to on Overpass thus far. Cloud9 certainly needs to secure some more in the bag. We can see that the money is pretty poor here for Overpass. So Cloud9 are starting to gain some momentum on the economy. Starting to gain control there. And is that sign in German?
Looks like it.
What does that mean?
No swimming in a toxic waste, basically.
Oh, that's hilarious.
Yes, I wouldn't be doing that, that's for sure. Now we've got 4 people in upper for the T side, and Shroud's going to push, maybe go for the flank here, but he doesn't know where they are just yet. We'll hear that flashbang go down, and that will raise his rabbit ears to try and figure out what that means. We can see Swag is playing that passive position, just waiting for a CT to overextend, but Shroud... flank is real, and he's up against the eco. Only Swag has the AK, and he's gonna just stay where he is for the moment. Shroud is gonna go down though, and that is gonna be 4-4 with 2 rifles now for iBuyPower.
And we're gonna see iBuyPower trying to scrap something together here. Swag will go down on the receiving end of that M4A4. Hiko making himself some more kills here. And it is the AZK to get a quick double there, taking down nothing in Hiko, and that's going to open up the round significantly. However, his friend Dazed can't get one of the weapons, but the attention is drawn away from the A-bomb site. That's going to allow Dazed to get the plant, so that's nice. That is certainly a big result, and the problem is now for Dazed that he has to try to delay somehow. As CTs will be on that site very fast, and AZK, he's going to be ending up there very slowly. So we'll have to see how this works out now, as Cloud9 are on top of the bomb site. They are making their way in very cautiously, though, trying to combine forces, as we have Sean Gez whiffing a shot. Over goes the HE, as Daze does put some bullets in the back of Senfis. Sean Gez now trying to play with Daze, but it's Daze does find the kill, and wonderfully Wonderfully done there by iBuy Power. I mean, really, AZK with that double. That was the round.
That was really well done there by iBuy Power, and they're keeping it neck and neck. Only two rounds behind at the moment, but the money is poor for both teams here. So again, whoever loses this round is going to be in trouble. They may or may not be able to force it up. And we've got the AWP on Skadoodle, but none for Cloud9 in this particular map, match, round, even. So again, we've got three people in upper. We've got AZK just holding a passive position in connector area, and then Swag with an extremely passive position heading towards the B bomb site. So they're making sure they're going to have no people flanking them. But Sean Garrett is going to be having a butchers at the long haul area. He will look away just as Skadoodle brings out the AWP, so that's probably a good thing for Sean Garrett's health.
I like that mixing in the Cockney rhyming slang there. So it's good stuff. And we're going to see Iowa Power slowly making their way towards the B side now. As nothing's on the angle, it could do a lot of damage. Ooh, wow, actually finds, I think, the headshot through the wall. And did you watch Thunderbirds?
Absolutely, I was a big fan.
Thundercats as well?
Yep.
Because the Iowa Power logo always reminds me of that for some reason.
Yeah, we can get back onto that later. It's the main guy with red hair.
Yeah, we're going to see Iowa Power making their way in slowly now, as they do have a threat level towards A and B, but it's going to be Steel to cut off the head of Shroud. That's really nice. That's over towards the A site. It's going to provide a nice bit of a distraction here towards this for this B take, and we are going to see them going in now. The fire does get dropped, and Cloud9 have certainly figured this out at this point. Kills coming down. It's hard to make it up that ramp there with Stemphis on the angle with the M4, but it's going to be nothing to put the stop onto Swag, as we have Steel wrapping around now, just trying to get that kill. Gets the one and one. Steel makes it, and iBuy Power going to pick up one more.
So close, but no cigar there, as the counter terrorist win, because the time ran out just before Steel got the frag.
I was so engrossed in that frag, that one on one, that I missed it. And Cloud9, I mean, they're looking pretty hot here.
Yeah, well, they're doing well. They could do better based on how the map has been going for the CTs. But 8-5, nothing to sniff at. It's a quite good score so far, and they could potentially make it 10.
This is madness here from Sean Gez. He's very close, very aggressive here on this angle, and he is going to suffer right now. Steel gunning him down. Shroud, though, trying to back him up, but Shroud's going to get taken out as well. So considering the buy of iBuy Power, this is really nice here from them. As Cloud9 do throw those bodies aggressively at them. It's a 3-on-3 already, and the bomb is down there. As Cloud9 have two players towards it. They do smoke it off. Very curious situation emerging now. Steel will take down Hiko, and that's going to give them a man advantage. That bomb's still down, though, and controlled by the CT, so.
Got the flank coming in here from Dazed. Going to try and find the CTs, but not entirely sure as to where they are. And we're going to find Steel just hiding behind the toilet. It's going to come out at an opportune moment and find Stemphis unaware. So 8-6 here. Now we go into the final round of this second half. And the money on the Cloud9 team is sparse, to say the least.
This is actually looking really grim now for Cloud9. I mean, you would have expected perhaps a few more rounds, maybe a bit of an ill-advised aggressive move considering the buy coming from iBuy Power. I mean, already at the ranges, Cloud9 had an edge, but they took it to the close ranges here for the aggression. But in the going and seeing more action coming in here as all those players just crash together. And it's going to be now AZK and Swag to save this for iBuy Power, as Cloud9 are looking pretty hot now as AZK tries to defend up the stairs, blindly shooting around the corner, and Swag going to pick up a single kill. But AZK does go down. Swag limited on the health, and it's going to be the single spud shot into the body of Swag there that does save Cloud9, give them the 9-6 half.
When that its single shot came in, all I thought was one tap salad, which I'm guessing you don't know that reference.
No.
It's from the slap chop infomercials in America. This guy has this big device that he uses to chop vegetables, and he puts some vegetables underneath it, gives it one tap, and then decides he decrees it salad underneath. So it's actually quite amusing. And I have a friend who actually got me one of those for my birthday, which is on my shelf. I will never, of course, use it, but I do find it highly amusing. Anyway, Cloud9 going to be on the T side now. Three rounds ahead here. Hyperpower did win the pistol when they were on the T side, so we'll see if Cloud9 can do the same. I'm quite curious as well on the buy rounds to see where Hyperpower, so where Cloud9 choose to put their runners. They're going to put two in connector here. And we're going to have bodies in B for the CTs. They're going to be pushing Sewer, AZK trying to find some information here. And we've got Days going up for the balcony peak. I am still playing close door, and AZK is going to be right behind him as well.
So Skedaddle going to draw first blood, it would seem, onto Sempfis, as we do have Hyperpower positioned quite well, actually, to stop this these positions just outside of B being taken to secure the usually what players will do is they'll use those positions to actually find the spots into the site before they actually make the push into the site. And this is pretty strong to take this. Oh, wow, yeah, you can see the power there, trying to catch them at that choke point. And still going to get a couple kill there. And it's like they are getting returned, though, as they slowly are able to force their way through that point onto the site itself. Shroud going to drop Dazed at distance now, as he does hop up, only to get taken down by the Skedaddle. He managed to get himself quite the quad kill. And we're going to have the round going to Hyperpower as they start off well here for the CT side.
Okay, so Cloud9's lead is reduced to two more rounds. We'll see where they go with the next round. This is round 17 of a possible 30. There is overtime in the FACEIT League as well. There must be a winner here at the FACEIT League. So we'll see what these two teams have to offer this round. Again, we've got the CTs moving forward, just closing down a map slowly but surely. We've got nothing in that connector area. Looking for a quick frag. He's going to open a door and... Steel's not going to hear him. He's going to jump over. He's going to pick up that Mag 7, and he will either hold an angle or retreat to join up with his teammates. Keep the element of unknown their most powerful tool. And Daze is going to come out to the long area and find someone to discuss things with. But they're going to be talking with guns, and Sempfis takes out Daze, and the T's are going to move on that towards the A bomb site.
All right, so I'm about suffering dramatically so. They able to actually save this, though. It's going to be Cloud9 in with all five players soon onto this A bomb site. AZK does take down nothing. Much more work to be done, though, for AZK with that FAMAS. Swag is going to make his way in slowly but surely. AZK going to go for the peak. He's going to find the end of Hiko's CZ. And Swag is now slowly coming up on the approach. But he's not to find all that much fun up here. It's four angry Cloud9 players already ready to spot him. As we do see the jump there from Sean Gez. And the exit's going to get caught in the side of the head, though. Swag meeting an untimely demise. As we do see 10-7 now, as Cloud9 fight back with a very wonderfully played second round. That's that's a buy coming in from them, and that the execution was just on point.
Cloud9, Hyperpower are going to find themselves on the eco now. We've got P250s on Steel and Swag. Other than that, it's bare bones cupboards for the IBP team. So let's see if we see this, an aggressive peek here through Sewer from the CT side, trying to glean some information. And Hiko will take down Steel, so that's one down and four to go for IBP in the eyes of Cloud9. So we have, let's look at the positions here. Hiko again, just playing those that range game, looking out for information. We've got Shroud, he's in connector with the bomb carrier, who is going to be nothing as well. So they've got the trade frags. You know, it's kind of like protect the VIP in old school CS, but the
I missed that.
VIP is with the bomb.
Yes, what was it, oil rig? It's the best map. Here we go, though. Wow, bit of a jump there.
Yeah, the internet went a bit bananas, but...
But we're back in the mix indeed. So we have ourselves three players left for Hyperpower. Ooh, gets a lot of damage. So that's actually a weapon as well. The Hammer's picked up, but one timely peek there from nothing going to take him down. And it's going to be AZK and Swag now to see if what damage that they can do. Certainly would be very important for Hyperpower to find that here right now. But Hiko, around the corner, that spray. But somehow, some way, AZK and Swag able to take him down. And that's that should be another gun in the mix. Swag does pick up the AK. Does actually pick up another frag with it too. So Swag on already. Good opportunity to maybe pick up Morris Shout is really low, but it's going to be the round for Cloud9 once again, as they start to swing into a very nice situation when it comes to the money, that is for sure. And iBuyPower certainly going to have to eco once again. They could always actually buy up quite a few bits and bobs here with that much money, but they are going to keep it very light, it would seem.
Yeah, they want to save their economy for their full buy round here, as they do expect to probably lose these. I don't think we've seen many, if any, eco rounds won so far on this map today, or possibly one actually, but memory's not with me at this time in the morning. So let's see. The CT's playing aggressively together. We have 1, 2, 3, and 4. All in close proximity. They can rotate with each other if needed. So we'll see if Shroud does choose to engage one of these ticking time bombs here. And we've got very passive bomb play here from Nothing. He's not going to want to show it to them. You can see him on the radar on the top left here. But Shroud is going to get moving here. And we can see if he manages to engage before Skidoodle or Daze engage him. And his teammate's going to run distraction. He's going to come from the back and make two frags here. And then they're going to open the door, close it again. Be careful with these eco rounds. But Steel does push the door and get two frags, bringing it back to a 3-2 in favor of iBuyPower here. They do have an AK as well. And his teammates can rotate and pick up a second gun.
Going with a quick kill. Hiko does take down Swag. And we have Cloud9 making their way in. Hiko with number two. It's just Steel to be found now, already working on that double. There's a triple there for Steel, as Nothing looks on, but can do nothing to help his teammate before he does get taken down by Steel. So, one down now for Nothing. Very nice situation for him to play with. All the pressure is now on Steel. He's going to go down, so well played there by Cloud9. In the end, it was a very rough round, but they managed to secure it in the end. And here we go. We can see the crazy good money now for iBuyPower to make that really solid full buy. And especially when you've got the M4A4s in the mix, you do need to save that much extra. We're going to see the AWP on Skidoodle once again. So this is where things have to go better for iBuyPower if they want to really climb back in this game here. They've got to break that bank of Cloud9. It's starting to get a little bit mad.
We have a rush here from Cloud9 towards the bomb site, so they're looking to just destroy the CT economy now they finished doing their ecos. It's going to be a trade here with an AK and a grenade getting the frags there. But Steel is going to take out Senfis with an aggressive peek and make it a 3-3. The smoke is going to go down, which will hopefully make the bomb easier to plant, but the bomb is on the floor at the moment. Now they have a one-man disadvantage. Bomb goes down again, and it's going to be a 15 HP Hiko to clutch versus 3 CTs.
Done crazier things, but not this time. And the interesting thing was that looked like, in theory, it should have worked, because iBuyPower were playing that kind of aggressive, expansive early round style, and we saw that they were pretty heavily out of position when that rush hit immediately. That's almost like the counterplay to that, to just funnel through in that way. But iBuyPower managed to actually hit the shots on the move, and they managed to do so quite effectively. And they stopped that pretty hard. I mean, they had three players left alive at the end of that. And now Cloud9 are actually looking at this eco. So iBuyPower is certainly on the road back here. But Skidoodle, what's he going to find? He's got three players. Does make a tag, actually. There's the finishing blow. Gets the headers around the overkill. Number two. Skidoodle's going to get more, though. They're right in front of him. And he's going to get taken down. That's an AWP there for nothing. And I would be pretty afraid right now to get picked by that. So what kind of angles are they going to play here? Going to cut down those ranges. Steel does actually find the kills, though, and it is another round for iBuyPower as we move into round 22. And Cloud9 already looking better than all the past five results. And looks like they didn't pick the AWP up in time there.
Yeah, that's going to be an expensive miss for them. So we're going to be running with Skidoodle here, who has the AWP. He's going to go for that quick peek through that sewer, but Hiko's going to be in position already, and that's going to be an early pick down and early disadvantage for iBuyPower. Another one goes down, that stays losing to Senfis, and Shroud takes out Steel as well. So iBuyPower not doing well at the moment, and we might see finally a win here on the scoreboard versus iBuyPower for Cloud9. I'm sure they'll be very happy to get that monkey off their back.
I love that. That was a cool pop flash there from Swag. AZK, though unable to capitalize, does go down. They try to find an aggressive player risk to get back into the game, but it didn't go their way. And now Swag is left to deal with five players with this AWP. There is number one. Swag, though, is going to get hunted down. And looks like Swag might just go for a quick peek here. Might find himself another frag to make it. Barely avoiding that, barely surviving. Nice grenade, won't make the kill though. And we do have Cloud9 taking that one. They're looking really good here. They are, oh, I mean, I think that was the best result in the last five matches for them was something like 12 rounds, I think, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, well, they are surpassing that, and they are in a good position to take the W here. Scudito going for the AWP once again. Really needs to make it work and get these early entry frags there with aggressive positioning from that AWP, but also they have to go the right direction to, in comparison to the other guys. And again, we've got safety in numbers here. T's going towards that B bomb site, and Swag is holding an angle here, so he will be able to tell his teammates to come and help him out. The Molotovs come in, and Swag will be forced to change his position before he dies. But Zenfus and nothing, taking out two people on the B bomb site, and that is almost going to be completely empty for this smoke plant.
But it is still sneaking into a very good position. Does take down the planter. That's a big, big play from the man Steel. Oh, and he does get taken out, but the job was already done. Does make it now a winnable round for his team. The delay on the plant and evening things up a little bit. They still have a man advantage, but Skadoodle takes care of that. There's two players left for them to deal with. Skadoodle finds number two. There is still a Senfist left alive as the Molotov does come in there. He needs to get that bomb down soon, but he's so exposed regardless. And Senfus slowly making his way, closing the distance. And another one is going to bite the dust in that round. Senfus going down. And it's going to be that opening play by Steel, followed up by Skadoodle, that really saved that fire by power. And if they had lost that round, we all saw how bad their money was. Cloud9 were looking very good to just take the match. But now things are certainly on once again. And this round means two for either team, I think.
Cloud9 going to force it up here, and they're going to have less people approaching the B bomb site in the initial stages of this round. Now we've got Shroud pushing towards middle up to that connector area, and then we're going to have some passive play, it looks like, on the A bomb site here and the long area. So we can see Sean Garrez is fishing around the area to see if he can find some CTs, and Scudoodle is going to be his equal there with the AWP. So we won't see that one just yet, but we may see it later on today. So here's Senfus now. Does get the connection on Scoodle. The anti-sister nade comes in. And things are going to slow down here as the CTs stack the bomb sites.
Yeah, very tense. It's I like this approach a bit better from Overpower. Just staying tight to the sites. They've been caught out of position repeatedly. Cloud9 have been hitting the fast plays to actually exploit the fact that IBP have been spreading out into the middle of the map, giving them like faster positions onto the site. It's only through clutch play that IBP have been able to save rounds such as that. And so now they are adapting our IBP to the pace that Cloud9 have been playing with. And we'll have to see if that pays off for them now, as the bomb does get planted. What's that B bomb site? So I'm going to pick up a kill on Sean Gares there on the A side, but they have to get this site under control if they want to win this round. And they've got to do it pretty shortly. There's only two players left to do that job. Still, good damage done there. So he will go down though. Senfus in control of the situation. And Dazed is just going to sit there with his AK. And not much more for him to be for him to really do in this situation, so you can't blame him. Here they come though, hunting them down. And he's going to hear that stepping. Now that was, I'm not sure if that was how worth it that was, but either way.
Yeah, there was a potentially cheap kill to be had, but no.
This reward is not really.
Yeah, you don't know. There are three T's running around looking for you, so not. You know, sometimes they're going to be behind him and they're going to take you out, whether you kill him or not, and that's one of those occasions. So
an AK in this round could have been a pretty big deal, but either way, it's in the past. It's best not to dwell. Hindsight is 2020. And IBP definitely looking to cause some damage here, but Cloud9's approach is assuredly very defensive, a very, very defensive posture from them as they realize that the money situation is quite bad for Overpower and they don't want to be surprised. So they're making sure that they're covering all their bases and checking all the positions correctly and sticking together for the most part.
Okay, so they are slowly approaching Skadoodle here, who's moving back towards the bomb site. So he may see them late, if at all. And again, the T's slowly taking over the map, slowly but surely. Senfis does take out Daze, and things will speed up here as they approach A. The bomb is going to take the lead here, and they need to make sure that doesn't fall down in an unfavorable place. No deaths yet here for Cloud9. Senfis is going to have the bomb, and we'll plant it behind the smoke there as we see the last player, Swag, just coming up the stairs. He only has the pistol, so it's going to be all in or nothing for IBPower in the next round.
Cloud9 going to take it, and that's match point now for them. IBPower with a very steep climb indeed to bring this to an overtime, and really it's going to be down to this attempt with a force buy that's really going to be the deciding... Going to be the only round that they can possibly obviously have to bring this back. So $2,800 on AZK, $3,300 on Swag, $3,300 on Skadoodle. Oh, this does look bad, doesn't it, for Overpower?
Yeah, it's less than ideal. That is most definitely for sure. So I think we have a small server delay here, so hopefully it will pick up again in a second. It is 15:10 here, and so we'll see if this continues shortly. So, Tempest with 27 kills here. AZK only with 8 on the IBPower team. He and Swag lagging behind at the moment. And Shroud with 17, so it's kind of good spread across the Cloud9 team. And we'll see.
I feel like Cloud9 have been playing much better against the strategies that they've been seeing against IBPower. I feel like they've been kind of reading the game quite well. Again, then it's all going to be over. That's sad times there.
I have a pair. I'm really looking forward to eating my pair after this stream. Just want to go on record as saying that, guys. It's not that controversial, but I had to get it out there. Thank you very much.
Is that your favorite fruit? Or
apricot is my favorite fruit.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'm an apricot man.
Oh, okay, well, we're going to jump into the game on that note. And
move 50 on.
There we go. So we have the very scrappy buy here for IBPower. And well, perhaps, I was going to make a very bad joke, but I will avoid that entirely. All right, so Cloud9, all they have to do is win one round. You can see that they have, you know, pretty solid money situation. They got all the weapons, all the buy that they need. And so far, they've been outpacing IBPower in many of the rounds. See if Swag can put in some damage there close to the pipe. That's the Swag 7. Had to be done. Looks like they are actually going to move further towards the B site from middle area now, and it's looking actually quite bad for Overpower already. Going to start to see that weapon disadvantage really come into play now, as Cloud9 are looking for the boosts, looking for the nades, looking for the wall bangs, as we see the grenades flying on in. And there goes nothing, gets taken down from the site. AZK with 2 with that 5-7. And that's some dirty, dirty stuff there from him as Cloud9 do even up the scoreboard. In fact, do better than that. They're man up right now. Make that 2 man up as Daze is going to go down. And boom, there it is. Good game, ladies and gentlemen. That is going to be the victory there for Cloud9. So that's 2 in a row for them. And I'm sure they're very, very pleased with that outcome. But yeah, that's it. That was it.